yesterday we have used the class attribute, right? In today's episode, we will see how to write the CSS in different ways. External CSS, internal CSS, and inline CSS. How to write the external CSS? Before going to understand the external CSS, let's discuss the internal CSS first. So here we have the H1 tag, right? And the paragraph tag inside this body tag. If you notice here, we have used the style tag inside the heading, right? Inside style tag, we have the styles given to these selectors. This body is called as selector. This H1 is called as selector. So when we run this web page, what happens is it will check for the body selector. This body will take the background as red. Similarly here, H1 selector will be selected inside this body tag. So wherever H1 is present, that will be given this style, color and margin left, right? So this is how CSS works. Writing the CSS inside the HTML file is called as internal CSS. This style is written inside this HTML file, right? This is one HTML file, .html file. Inside this HTML, we have this style, that's why it is called as internal CSS. What is inline CSS? Here, we have written the H1 tag. But the style is written inside this H1 tag only. So this style is called as an attribute and these are called as values. And this is called as property and this is called as value. Using the style attribute inside the tag is called as inline CSS. What is external CSS? Suppose here you have one HTML page. Inside this HTML page, there is no CSS written. Using the style tag. The style tag is written in some other file. So to connect these two files, this is HTML page and this is your style page. To connect this, we have to use this link rel as style sheet and the path of the file where it is stored. So let me show you this in practical, how to use this. For that, we have to open the Visual Studio Code. Let's open this. Okay, here we have the basic structure of HTML, right? Let's create one paragraph here. This is paragraph. Okay, now here if I run this page, what will happen? Let's run this first. This is paragraph. Now what I want is I want to give the color to this paragraph. I want to give the color to this paragraph using external CSS. Using inline CSS, we can use this way, color as red. Okay, so this is a way for writing the inline CSS inside the tag. Let's run this now. You can see the red color is applied. If I don't want to use the inline CSS, I will use the internal CSS as well. Color as red. But how? Inside head tag, we have to apply the style tag. Like this. So this is way of writing the internal CSS. Let's run this. You can do this as well. Now, if I don't want to write this inside my HTML file, what I will do is, now let's see the output. This is a paragraph, this is a black color because there is no styling present here. Now, what I will do is go here to your project directory. Here you have the new file, right? New file and give file name as external.css. So make sure you add the .css extension here. Now here we will apply the style. I will use paragraph selector and color as purple. Okay. Or we can use the green color, simple. Now we have to connect both these files. So for that, as I have shown, you have to use the link rel is equals to style sheet and href is equals to the name of your external file. external.css, like this. Now if you run this, the color of this text is changed to green. How it is happening? The entire code of CSS is written inside this file, right? Now what happens is when we write this line, all the CSS code, this entire CSS code will be written here, but we cannot see that. That will be visible only to the browser who is running this HTML, right? Similarly, if I write heading tag here, this is heading 1 here. Here, if I write the CSS for that as well, you can use this as well, right? It will check for h1 selector inside this file, where is h1, and assign the color as purple. Let's run this. See, you can assign multiple CSS styles as well. For example, if you want to add some internal style as well, you can do that even if the external style sheet is present. Here, if I want h1 should be of color red, but if you notice here inside this file, we have the h1 color as purple, and inside this HTML file, which color is we have given? Red. So what will be the final output of this h1? This will be this red, because this is written inside this. Then that's why internal CSS will get more preference than external CSS. Similarly, if I write style is equals to here and color it as brown, so which color will be added? This purple, this red, or this brown to this h1? So the brown will be selected color, because this is more close to this h1. More closer the style, more preference will be given to that, right? If I run this now, brown color will be added. I hope you got the basic understanding of inline, external, and internal CSS. Let's discuss about CSS selectors.